out of them. I think it's Bella Hall, and the state board of education. Before I do justice here, I would like to really thank everyone again. Especially the officers, the officers, and this opening. This is our second year of this program. Last year, Pastor Paul, he had a vision. He got together with the pastors, and he called the ball game. And we worked at it. It's all to keep up, Pastor Paul. And I went to visit him. He's a worker. And I want to thank him. We all should thank him for his vision. He had a vision. This is the second year, and I can see it continue to grow and grow and prosper. He has a committee of people with him. I don't know all names. I don't know Pastor Paul. But from all we stand, he's involved in his vision. This time, I'd like to introduce you to a great friend of mine, Mr. Jeff, who is a man of many, many accomplishments. However, I believe his greatest attributes all. See, I know him. Here's some of his greatest attributes. He loves me. Dad, Jay, Jill, and their spouses. Also, a part of the family are his dogs. She has a great love. Governor Jeffers has a great love for all young people. He's willing to do anything in power for young people to succeed. I remember when he went a couple years ago for governor. He talked about education. He talked about young people as being a centerpiece. He has to have a change. He's not doing a change. It's like a core of an album. You've got to have a core. His core is education. His love for his kids is not a condition. Notice I said his kids. He look at every kid in this arena tonight as his own. Because that's just the way he is. Governor Justin loves Valley Island instead of West Virginia. Just like we love the state of West Virginia, we love our schools, we love the entire state. If he didn't, he would leave everything. Because that's just the way Governor Justin operates. It bothers him when we are not as successful as we could be in number of your rankings. We always talk about 50, yeah? We're going to do better than that. We're going to get the legislature. We're going to rise above 50. We're going to rise above 40. But you got to follow the leaders. He has a tremendous vision for all, and includes all voices across the state. Come together to make education. All voices, students, parents, staff, teachers, administrators, all across the state, you have to become as one. Education has to be the top dog. If not, we won't improve. We won't move forward. Young people already talked to you about that. He's going to graduate tonight. He's going to graduate this week. Education is important. We got to believe that. Our backbone was for our children to be successful. Governor Justice has listened to all voices. She has led with his one focus. We need hope. We need a visionary. We have that. Of the Jim Justice. So without further delay, I now present to you Mr. Jim Justice, Francis Governor, West Virginia, one vision, one focus.
Imagine this. Imagine an 11-year-old boy
I was in the next to last house on a dead end street, rented house, little cemetery right across the road. A little boy that grew up with his grandparents had never had any more plumbing. Now we've got some real dignitaries here tonight, you know, whether they be Roland or whoever it may be, and I kind of can't. My vision is getting away now. But one of the dignitaries is here. Just introduced me, Miller Hall, a great man, a real friend, a friend, a lifetime friend, and I'm just so proud of him, it's unbelievable. He's doing great work right now for our State Board of Education, and he's done great work as our principal, Woodrow Wilson, and on and on and on. But the guy right beside him, now he's old. Roger Paul, think about this just for a second. 50 years ago, he marched in graduation right here. Now, there are rumors that this skinny kid marched at the same time. And it's true. Right here. 50 years ago. We came into the new high school with Woodrow Wilson as juniors. And some way it survived us for 2 years. In some way now it's carried on. I can never, ever congratulate the kids from all across the area that have been invited to come here today and that are here with you today. I can never congratulate all those who aren't able to, that have been not able to attend today. 15 area churches have worked really, really hard to make this a reality. Now let's just think just for a second, just one thing. And that's just this. You in West Virginia are, in my opinion at least, the best of the best of the best. People say it all the time. I'm living proof. I'm living proof to you that you can do anything. Anything. If you just put your mind to it and you have the passion, you can do anything with your life. Think about me. Think about me. Think about a little skinny kid that grew up or started his life on 4th Street in West Virginia with grandparents with no indoor plumbing that's sitting in front of you today talking to you as your governor. Think about that. You can achieve whatever you choose to achieve. Now let me just talk just a second about just this. The reason that I ran for governor is one thing. You know, I believe in West Virginia, and I love West Virginia, and I often say that no one loves it more. There may be people that love it as much, but no one loves it more. You know, I would say this without any qualifications whatsoever. I believe you're the best. I believe you're the most caring, the most loving, the best craftsman. You know that years ago when we didn't have any jobs, and there was all kinds of jobs around Charlotte or different areas of North Carolina, there were lines and there were people that needed people so badly, and there was 100 people in the line, and the people that were hiring would walk the lines and say, is there anybody here from West Virginia? And if they found them, they pulled them out immediately because they knew they were good people and they knew how to do something. And they hired them. That's you. That's you. Did you ever just think that we've been the blunt end of a lot of bad jokes along the way? It's not fair. It's not very funny. That's why I ran. I didn't run for anything whatsoever. It was me. Believe me, I had enough in my life. But the empty point in my life was just this. How in the world could the place that's so good be beat on so much? And we were. Things are better today. I would even say things are unbelievably good, but there's still lots to do because there's still lots of rocks to flip over. I will tell you this, as you, as graduates, go through your life, you may think it's been really tough, and I congratulate you to have achieved what you've achieved, and you may think it's really tough to have gotten to where you've gotten to, and I'd say, it's only going to get tougher. You know, really, I am a sole believer, I am a total believer in this. And that is, God made Jim Justice for a reason. He made you who you are for a reason. And absolutely, throughout your life, you will have tests and troubles and stress like you can't imagine at times. I'm going to tell you right now, in my life, there's plenty of people who throw a lot of really, really unfair rocks. And they're really tough. And really, really hurt your feelings. And you want to just say, for gosh sakes, a living, why can't they understand the truth, the real truth? And then I think it's this. The one that will never, ever leave your side is the good Lord. And he's always there. And he'll only push you to what you can really handle. But he'll push you. I guarantee you, through your life, you'll have all kinds of trials and tribulation. And you know what? Because you have a relationship with God, you will absolutely propel yourself and overcome. What you are doing here is just unbelievable. What these people are doing is unbelievable. And they're all doing it in the name of God. You know, a lot of politicians dance around that. A lot of politicians won't really come right out and say, I stand with God, or I am a Christian through and through, or I have values of God. Not me. You see, I've never really been a politician. I do a lot of stuff. And a lot of times it gets so tough that you make mistakes. But I'll go to my grave with this. I never, nor will I ever, do anything in life to self-serve myself that I know is inaccurate to do. You know, I have made the foundation of my life on truth and honesty and honor. And first and foremost, God. Secondly, my family. Third, my employees, and now my employees in the entire state. And fourthly, kids. Now you may think, well, does he put kids last? No way. But you see, in my playbook, that's all I have time for. God. My family, all the people that work for this great state and are my employees, and lastly, kids. And I just run that play over and over and over and over. That's what I do. So you kids, listen to me. The sky's the limit. You may think today, oh, I can't wait to get out of West Virginia. I can't wait to cross the mountain to the other side where things are so much brighter, so much better. And you know what's going to happen to you? You may do that. And I say, take that journey if that's what your heart is telling you to do. Take that journey. Do you know what you'll do? You will, before long, you will start longing for the place that made you who you are. That made you who you are. You are West Virginians, and your family is West Virginians, and your faith base is in West Virginia. Truly, you'll want to come home. And you know what? It's my job, and I take it dog seriously. It is my job in life to provide you opportunities where home is where you'll want to be. We're getting better, and I'm going to work every moment of the day decided today is the little, what little sound bite can we tell to a 10-part story, one part, and be one up on somebody? Don't do that. Don't do that in your life. There's so much more to life. The last thing I'll say is just this. Remember that skinny kid. Really, truly. Remember that skinny kid. And think just this way. And this is for you kids. Today in the state of West Virginia, we have a terrible situation with drugs. You know, if there's scenes that I could line up and say, well, what do you want to do as your governor? Well, I want to provide you economic opportunity and jobs and jobs and jobs. I want to absolutely be committed to education like I am out of my mind. I want to someway fix these crazy roads. And the last thing is not the last thing, because there's so many other things. You know, the good stuff we've done for the veterans and on and on and on. The, you know, the exemption of Social Security taxation. So many other good things. But the last leg of the stool is drugs. The drugs are cannibalizing us. And we've got to conquer that problem. But kids, I will leave you with that skinny kid that played for the Crescent Chipmunks in the first game ever played in this place right here. And we lost in the county championship. But praise the Lord, I was only a fifth grader because we came back the next year and won it right here. That was good. But remember that skinny kid that hates to admit that he's as old as Roger Paul. But that skinny kid went on to college in a time in the late 60s and everything with drugs and Woodstock and everything was going on. It was as bad as bad to be. I'm telling you, that little skinny kid had more fun than anybody in the world. Absolutely more fun than anybody. And I want to tell you, to God above, this very moment in my life, I've never experimented, tried, done one thing in any level of drug in my life other than eat too much. And then I grew another body. And this is one strong stool. But I'm telling you, you don't have to have drugs to have a lot of fun in life. You don't have to have drugs to have a way to get through the tough times. For crying out loud, there is so much to do in life that will lead you to opportunity beyond belief. Go get it. Go reach out and grab it. Grab it and absolutely tackle it and hold it down and let it take you to wherever you're. I'm so proud of you, so proud of all these people that made this happen, so proud that they invited me to come, and I can never be, never say any more than just this. Happy Mother's Day to all those wonderful, wonderful mothers, and please embrace them, and hug them, and thank your parents and all the people that have absolutely put you on your way. Go make them proud. Make them proud. Absolutely, don't disappoint. Make a